The CEO of Virgin Hyperloop joins us this morning, Jay Walder. Always good to see you, Jay. Congratulations.
Hey, thank you. Good to be here. And hey, before we before we do anything else, let me say something to our veterans and thanking them for their service. But thank you.
It's the most important thing to think about today, Jay. Thank you for that. How many unmanned tests did you do? And how was this really different other than that you had people inside?
Hey, you hit the nail on the head. We had already run over 400 tests on that facility in the Las Vegas desert. We proved that Hyperloop works. But what this did was to answer the question about that I get asked most often, is it safe? And we resoundingly answered that question. We had two teams go through, Josh and Sara, who you mentioned, and two of our other colleagues, Ann and Tanae, went through the next day. So it's absolutely spectacular.
I think we're looking at some pictures here now. How were they chosen, just out of curiosity, and any report cards from them on how it felt?
We actually asked all of our team, would you like to be the first person to ride in a Hyperloop pod? And we had over 40 responses, and then we narrowed down on the basis of physical tests, psychological tests. Josh Giegel, our co-founder and CTO, was standing at the front of the line all the time. He said, hey, I want to do this. It's our baby. And I love the fact that our own colleagues were the people who are in the pod and doing it. They loved it. They said that it was smooth and it was fun. I don't know if you're seeing the footage right now, but they've got smiles on their faces from ear to ear. And they had it during the ride. They had it after the ride. They had it when we went out for drinks after that. It was spectacular.
Jay, we are seeing the footage and we're seeing their big smiles or even fist bumping. According to PitchBook, I want to ask you about the finances. You guys have raised about $500 million, but I imagine this is a very capital intensive undertaking. What kind of funding are you looking at? Is an IPO, which would raise the profile of the project, to on the horizon for you guys?
Well, maybe at some point. Hey, look, it is a capital intensive project, but I think one of the things that we're showing is that we're knocking down the markers step by step. And I think that's what investors are really looking for. And I've had many of our investors coming back to me actually in the last few days and telling me how excited they are to see this and that the company's hitting its milestones and doing the work that we said we would do. This really positions us to go on to commercial activities. And I think that's the big part here. Like where this really is the transition point now to say, we've proven the technology, we've shown that it's safe, let's move forward to commercial activities. And an IPO certainly could be in the future at some point, but probably not right away.
Jay, how much uncertainty has the pandemic inserted into this market and this situation? I imagine there are a lot of cities, municipalities, governments now not clear on at what point public transportation usage will reach 100% again, what the design of that will need to be going forward, and certainly the feasibility of raising debt for that, given all of the other priorities that new priorities that governments are likely to have. What are you hearing?
You know, it's actually going the other way. And let's think about it for a second. No question. This is a terrible global pandemic, and it creates and there's no question about that. It's created challenges for our company. The tests that you saw, we brought out in the middle of this pandemic. But at the same time, I think one of the things that people are realizing is, A, we'd like to be together. B, we need mobility. And C, yes, we need to rebuild, but shouldn't we be evolving? And we've been struck by how many people are coming to us now and saying, we really do want to move forward. We really do want to think about how we do this. And I think the vision of super fast transportation, high capacity, flexible, able to move people and goods, mobility and logistics, and doing it in a way that's cleaner and greener. I mean, this is a transportation system that will not pollute the air that we breathe. I think that's resonating right now. And I think in some sense, the pandemic has helped people to shake off the cobwebs. Let's dream big about infrastructure again. We've done it before, we can do it.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.